Quick glance at any car showrooms this festive season will show you how auto dealers are doing their best to rouse the fanfare to sell more units. They are even taking on the risk of maintaining a higher inventory, which goes against the sentiment amidst the slowdown. Electronic retailers are stocking up too. All this while concerns still remain of availability of cheap and easy consumer financing. More importantly, there is a fear that festive season this time around may not bring the kind of blessings all manufacturers and retailers are hoping for. To get a deeper sense of how the season may pan out, let's speak to Arvind Singhal of Technopak Advisors, who serves as consultants to consumer firms. Mr. Singhal, thanks very much for taking out the time. What is the gauge of the sentiment currently for the festive season?
See, the festive season, there is a lot of optimism, but I'm not very sure whether it is just optimism, whether it is based on any strong fundamentals there. Having said so, the festive season has just begun. I think we have only gone into the first 2 weeks of this month. The season will last for another 2 months or more there. But, you know, when we talk about the consumer demand, I would like to present two different perspectives as well to keep it in mind. The demand of consumers is actually in two domains. One is the merchandise, other is services. I think we have to look into consumer demand in the combination of both services as well as merchandise. The reason I'm mentioning this to you is that consumer spending on some categories of services, education is one of those examples, leisure travel is the second category, and healthcare is the third category. These three categories increasingly have been taking a larger share of consumer spending in the last 5 or 7 years compared to merchandise spending. So there's a double whammy for companies which are physical retailers or brands, where there is an economic slowdown to start with. B, the consumer preference is shifting towards services from merchandise, and therefore it puts additional pressure on sales for merchandise.
So, you know, despite the kind of offers that we're seeing, price points getting reduced, discounts being offered, nothing so far has managed to really spur the need for consumers to come and buy a whole hog. Do you see that being a pain point for some time to come, despite, you know, you've got the marriage season coming up now, once Diwali gets over, and even if festive season is somewhat better, you'll be back to square once the festivities are over?
Unfortunately, it looks like, so let's talk about discounts. First of all, discounts are no longer a phenomena which is only largely just before the festive season. On the contrary, till about 10 years ago, festive season used to see no discounts. There was such a strong demand. So discount used to take place in what was the pre-festive season, which would have been the months of July and August. Now consumers are also smart. They know that there is discounting going on around the year. You know, for example, the e-commerce players just had their big billion days and whatever else. And almost as soon as it got over, Amazon is back again in the market with some fresh Diwali discounts. So consumers no longer get seduced only by the notion of discounts. They know very well that if something is not on discount today, it will be on discount tomorrow. Second aspect is like this, that even the marriage season is getting very staggered. It is no longer clustered only in the months of November and December or October or November. There. So while there is a significant amount of clustering still around these 2 months, but it is not that most of the weddings in Northern India in particular take place around this season only. It's reasonably well spread now across the whole year. So as a result of this, we might see a short blip, upwards blip, in the months of October, November and December. But unless something fundamentally goes positive for the economy, I'm afraid we will still see a subdued consumer demand in the subsequent quarters.
Yeah, it's Mr. Singhal, it's kind of playing out in the way the expectations from the staple stroke QSR companies are this quarter. The expectation is that the same store sales growth for the QSRs will remain low. Even for the staples, it would remain low. The only dichotomy out here seems to be the kind of sales that the electronic gadgets have shown in the sales on the online sales by Amazon and Flipkart. So is there a clear shift that everything else but electronics, which are now almost becoming staples, is not going through a good patch?
So, I think one has to be very careful when we say that the total share of online, and I'm not talking about only consumer durables and appliances, the total share of online sales compared to the merchandise sales in the country is less than 3%. So therefore, even if Amazon and Flipkart claim that their turnovers have increased by 50% like or by quarter and quarter, or there does not necessarily mean that all of India is buying more consumer durables and appliances. So that's first part. That the impact of Amazon and Flipkart on the overall consumer spending, it still remains very, very, very low. Having said this, it is true that consumer preferences are changing. They have changed significantly in favor of consumer durables. Refrigerators and air conditioners are two categories which have seen a significant amount of growth. TVs have seen relatively flat growth because I think more consumers are watching their entertainment on the smartphone compared to the big screen TVs there. But on the whole, even if our consumer durable sales are very good, it is not necessarily a dichotomy. It only reflects a certain amount of a behavioral shift as far as consumer preferences are concerned.
In which case, Mr. Singhal, in your experience, what leads this slowdown, if I can use that term, or a downtrend, if I can use that term, to turn around? Would it purely be sentiment, which is very difficult to figure out when it would happen? Maybe an income tax cut or otherwise could do that, or is it very difficult to predict that?
See, sentiment can only go as far. The assumption about sentiment is that people are sitting on money. That may be a flawed assumption to start with. The fact of the matter is that India has systemically seen not enough effort in creating high-value jobs. We do create jobs, a Swiggy, a Zomato, Uber, Ola are examples which are being talked about there. Those jobs are actually basically giving money for subsistence. The people who are in those jobs, do not have significant amount of disposable power. Unless the country moves towards creating an opportunity for larger number of people to fall into genuine middle class, the consumer sentiment might be an overplayed story there. We need to put more money in the hands of the consumers. So yes, certain amount of reduction in personal income taxes could put some additional money in consumer hands. But I think the problem is far more systemic. It is not a problem for one quarter or two quarters, according to me.
Mr. Singhal, just also weigh in on how the rural consumption has suffered. And for some of the bigger consumer staples, a bulk of the demand comes from the rural end. Do you feel that that will continue to suffer in the near term? And also the fact that the last few quarters, volume growth for some of these FMCG players have been subpar. When do you see that turning?
So again, I think the rural sector, especially the farming sector, actually requires again fundamental changes. The irony of India right now is that more the farmer produces, the lesser the income is, because we are at this moment actually having a situation where India is by and large producing much more food than what we need. Now, we cannot export most of this food, for there are other reasons for that. So as a result of that, the farmer, despite putting a lot of effort, the farmer's incomes are not going up. If the farmer's income don't go up, then at the end of the day, rural demand cannot go up either, because even the non-farming activity which is there in rural India, the primary source of revenue for the people to spend money comes out of the agricultural income. Now, this is where I think the Prime Minister did talk about doubling the farmer's income in X number of years, but I don't see any significant action being taken on the ground. Tinkering with MSP is actually just like giving aspirin to somebody who has a severe health issue there. So rural incomes also, unfortunately, will remain very, very, modest growth, if at all any growth there, because we haven't actually pulled people out of farm. We haven't pulled enough people out of rural India into non-farming activity. And for that, it required a huge impetus on manufacturing. So again, we talk about Make in India, but the reality on the ground, I think everybody sees that there is not much achievement so far on the Make in India as far as manufacturing is concerned. So rural incomes cannot be just dependent only upon a good monsoon or not so good monsoon or MSP. Fundamental changes are needed there as well. But sadly, I don't see those changes taking place.
cross fingers. Let's see how it all shapes up. I think this quarter earnings from some of the companies and the commentary thereof might also give some indication of how they feel. But Mr. Singhal, thanks so much for taking the time out and joining us and giving us your perspective.